why not 55 red with 59?
But
59 bhi padh lena.
59 relates to matters incidental or ancillary to any matter enumerated in this part.
So but it may not, like, zara sa, my understanding is I may be subject to correction. It may specifically be mentioned there, but it can expand.
Bilkul separate
kare. Bandari sahab shayad behtar jawab dein hain shayad. Yep. Sunte hain ko.
Ji sir, bilkul. Thank you very much for
thank you. You are a petitioner?
My lord, I am representing PTI. You're not.
Are you a petition number?
My lord, a notice was issued in all petitions.
Have you filed something?
My lord, I filed two concise statements. CMA 3933.
3933.
And CMA number 8351.
8351. What are the difference between the two?
My lord, the first was filed several months ago. The 8351 was filed yesterday in the light of the observations that have been made on the last date of hearing, the submissions made by counsel. I've tried to address some of the points that have come up during your lordship's observation.
No, first of all, tell me where you stand.
My lord, I am under instructions to support the petitioners, but with some caveats. I am not saying, and I'll just say this and then move on to my submissions. Well, I am not saying that the Parliament cannot per se make any law as far as the practice of the Supreme Court is concerned. It can, but that power is heavily circumscribed by various express and structural limitations within the Constitution. So that's heavily circumscribed. But within those limits, it can. And I'll expand on that. So as my Lord Justice Mansoor just said, there are two aspects to the...
First, finish your thing.
My Lord...
Then you come to what we have observed.
My Lord, yes.
You are conceding that the Parliament can, but their power is heavily circumscribed.
Heavily circumscribed.
Now, which particular provisions of this Act are you think the Parliament has exceeded its jurisdiction?
If I may, if you could first expound on your initial proposition. As far as the first point, if you could expound on that particular part. That the legislature has the power. Explain that. Move on to the issue which you're, where the restrictions are.
My lord, absolutely. That's exactly how I will address. And I will address both aspects of the law on this point. First aspect is the practice and procedure aspect. Sections 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. And then there is the appeal. And I'll address them separately. I'll come to start with the practice and procedure. Bit first. My Lord, the various articles have been read out before the court many times. My Lord, Article 1, let's start off with where the Parliament draws its legislative power from. There are two sources in the Constitution. One is Article 142, which takes us to the federal legislative list. The second are a set of provisions in the body of the Constitution which confer specific power on the Parliament to make laws on identified specific subjects. These are the two sources. Now, the question before your lordship and your ladyship, the question before the court is, as has come out in discussion recently, is whether Article 191 by itself, and I emphasize upon the words, my lord, by itself, is a source of legislative power. And my submission on that is that it is not. And I'll explain the reasons why I say that. My lord, your lordship has already seen the preamble to the... The preamble itself identifies the source of legislative power that the Parliament has invoked. It has invoked two sections, two articles, Article 175-2 and Article 191-2. My lord, let's just read both of them very quickly. And then compare their language to Article 142. Article 175, clause 2, says this. No court shall have any jurisdiction save as is or may be conferred on it by the Constitution or by or under any law. This is similar to, but slightly more specific than 191. 191 says, subject to this constitutional law, the Supreme Court may make rules regulating the practice and procedure of the court. Now your lordship may turn to 142. 142 is cast in different language altogether. It starts off by saying, subject to the constitution, A, Majlis-e-Shura, Parliament, shall have exclusive power to make laws with respect to any matter in the federal legislative branch. So the legislative power is conferred with respect to identified subjects. Subject to the constitution. And the appropriate legislature is identified. So that's how, in my humble opinion, you identify whether an article is a source of legislative power. It identifies the subject on which the legislature can enact law, and it identifies the legislature itself. Now, if your lordships go back to 175.2, it simply says, no court shall have any jurisdiction save as is or may be conferred on it by the constitution or by any law. It doesn't say what is the...
You may have keep, sir, clarify for me. You are saying Parliament does not have power to legislate except items mentioned in the federal legislative list. Is this what you are saying?
My lord, in the what is mentioned in the federal legislative
list? Yes or
list?
No?
Yes. And also on what is mentioned in the body of the constitution. And I'll just take your...
Okay, now I will give you an example. My reading of the fourth schedule, I mean, science is developing, artificial intelligence has evolved. Urdu mein isko shayad masnoi zehanat keh lein, outer space, khalai basit keh lein shayad, social media, samaji rabta keh lein. To inke mutalliq parliament kanoon nahi bana sakti hai, kyunki in teenon cheezon mein se ek ka bhi zikr federal legislative list mein bhi nahi hai, aur aain ki kisi shikh mein expressly ya impliedly bhi nahi hai. Ab jab aap attend kar lein mere sawal ko.
My lord, mere khayal mein bana sakti hai.
Aapne hi sawal ko tod diya, phir aapne hi jawab ko.
No, my lord. Aapne jo legislative list mein entries hain, unko to the maximum possible extent.
Yeah, maine teen example de di na. Inko kisi tar se bhi wahan nahi fit ho rahi hain. Aur na aain ki kisi aur shikh mein aa rahi hain. Ye baatein jo maine aapse zikr ki hain. तो फिर पार्लियामेंट के पास तो इख्तियार नहीं है ना. पाकिस्तान स्पेस प्रोग्राम नहीं शुरू कर सकेगा क्योंकि फेडरल लेजिस्लेटिव लिस्ट में इसका तस्करा नहीं है. या तो आप ये आर्ग्यूमेंट करेंगे कि नहीं, सिंध कर सकता है, वफाक नहीं कर सकता है, क्योंकि बाकी सारे इख्तियार फिर सूबों के पास हैं. ये तो आप जवाब दे देना.
मैं दे देता हूँ.
ऐसे ब्रॉड आप अगर पेंट ब्रश स्ट्रोक्स लगाएंगे तो उसके लिए अपनी मुश्किल भी खड़ी हो जाती है.
For example, with respect to space programs, if Pakistan has entered international treaties, then there are specific entries which allow Parliament to enact law for implementing international treaties.
कौन सा entry है बता दें?
Well, entry 3.
32.
Entry 3, external affairs, implementation of treaties. For example,
आप इसको सुन तो लीजिए ना, ऐसे ना करें ना, थोड़ा सा थोड़ी सी हमारी भी कदर कर लें. एंट्री 3 को ट्रीटीज के तो मैंने बात ही नहीं आपसे की. नहीं, सुन भी लेना, ट्रीटी की मैंने बात ही नहीं की. मैं तो आपको कह रहा हूँ पाकिस्तान चले ट्रीटी से खिलाफ ही कर रहा है काम. ट्रीटीज में क्यों जोड़ रहे हैं हम भाई? किसी को आउटर स्पेस में प्रोग्राम करना है, इंडिया ने किया है, वो ट्रीटी के जरिए कर रही है. अगर हम कल शुरू करना चाहें तो आपके मुताबिक हम नहीं कर सकते हैं, या कर सकते हैं तो अगर कर सकते हैं तो वो कौन सा पावर पार्लियामेंट इस्तेमाल करेगा?
लेजिस्लेटिव एंट्रीज में बहुत सी
बता देना मुझे.
फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं लॉर्ड, जैसे ये अगर इसमें ये न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी का
न्यूक्लियर की बात आया है,
उसके अंदर मैं लॉर्ड, आपने मकलक वर्सेस मेरीलैंड का केस
आप लोग इतने मुतासर हो गए हैं अमेरिकन. हम आपसे आप हमारा रिटर्न आईन है उसी हम बात कर रहे हैं, उनका आईन अपनी जगह है.
मैं आपकी जजमेंट जो कि आपने
भाई आप जजमेंट को छोड़ दीजिए ना,
सिविल एविएशन अथॉरिटी के केस में दी, उसमें आप
जरा ना तसल्ली से बहस करें ना.
बिल्कुल.
या तो आप ये आर्गुमेंट पेश ना करें. जब आप ये पेश करते हैं ये बहस सामने, या एक मफरूजा साहब करते हैं कि इट इज एज गिवन, तो मैं फिर ये मैं ये नहीं मानता हूँ। या तो मैं क्या मैं ये वापस लेता हूँ ये बात को, आप कहते हैं कि पार्लियामान सिर्फ वो काम कर सकती है जो 142 फेडरल लेजिस्लेटिव लिस्ट या एक्सप्रेसली या एम्प्लाइडली हो, उसके अलावा कुछ नहीं कर सकती। या तो कहें मैं ये बात को वापस लेता हूँ। अगर आप ये बात इस बात रहे हुए हैं तो मेरे सवाल का जवाब दीजिए, आप जवाब नहीं देते हैं। आप कहते हैं मैरीलैंड वर्सेस उसमें देख लें, उसको कम क्यों देखें?
माय लॉर्ड, मैं स्पेस टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में तो केस तैयार करके नहीं आया नहीं जी, मैं तो प्रैक्टिस एंड प्रोसीजर पे हूं, उस पे मैं सवाल
उस पे बात करें ना, फिर आप ये ब्रॉड स्ट्रोक्स ना पेंट कीजिए।
स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट तो मैं आपसे कहीं से,
आप ब्रॉड स्ट्रोक्स जब पेंट करते हैं अपने लिए मसले खड़े कर देते हैं, तो आप फोकस्ड रहें इसी बात पे।
मैं तो 142 काउंसिल जी,
लर्नड काउंसिल देखें, लर्नड काउंसिल एंट्री थ्री भी है, पार्ट आइटम 58 देखेंगे
जी,
आइटम 58
58
और दूसरा मुझे सिर्फ ये बता दीजिएगा,
पार्ट 2 एंट्री 3 तो देखें,
नॉट विद स्टैंडिंग आर्टिकल 191, आपका आर्गुमेंट ये है कि द पार्लियामेंट इज बिरेफ्ट ऑफ ज्यूरिसडिक्शन टू लेजिस्लेट इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ एनी ऑफ द फंडामेंटल राइट्स और एक्सेस टू जस्टिस।
My Lord, I have not articulated my argument as yet.
अगर आप ये अगर आप कर लें, I think बेहतर होगा अगर आप
पहले आप you argue as you want. Argue as you want. Please go back to your. I apologize. You argue as you want.
Your Lordship, not apologize.
चलिए चलिए करिए करिए करिए.
My Lord, for 2 days I have heard all our questions.
करिए
Let me address those questions.
Yes,
is what I'm saying.
My Lord, I will answer your Lordship's question also.
अब आप कर लीजिए ना.
My Lord, the starting for legislative competence is entry article 142 or the body of the constitution. Now body of the constitution for our present purposes, the only article relevant is article 191. In the legislative list there is entry 55. Now these are the two provisions that have to be interpreted and read. Article, as I read article 175(2), the expression subject to law, which is used in 191, is used in various other articles also. That by itself does not confer any legislative power or any on any identified legislature. Just kindly look at Article 14.
Article
14.
14. Of man.
Dignity of man.
Article 14.
It says, the dignity of man and subject to law, the privacy of home shall be inviolable. The law, the province will make the law or the federation will make the law.